Hello everyone and welcome to my new video on stock market. In this video, I'm going to discuss about or I'm going to analyze Godrej Agrovet share. So I will talk about how this company actually makes money, then I will talk about their financial numbers, and at last I will give my view on this stock. And also do not forget to subscribe to my channel so that you keep on getting updates from my channel. So do press the subscribe button so that you do not miss on any updates from this channel. And of course, that will also motivate me in making more this type of videos. Now, if you see the name itself, right? Godrej Agrovet. So Agrovet is a combination of agriculture and veterinary. So veterinary is for like animals and agro means agriculture, right? So this company actually deals with both of these. So I will show you like in which sectors they are actually. So of course, it's the name itself, you can see, right? It's a Godrej Group company. And others like Godrej Group companies are GCPL, Godrej Consumer Products Limited, Godrej Properties, Godrej Industries. These all are very big companies in India. And they are trying to make this Godrej Agrovet also as a big company. IPO for this company happened like in the last 3 years itself in 2017. So it's a new company in stock market. And this listed at a price of like close to around 600. It even went to 700, but now it's trading at close to like 460 rupees. Currently. Now let's look at how this company, in which sectors this company is and how this company actually makes money. This is important. You should understand how company actually makes money. If you see, they are into, I told you, they are agriculture plus veterinary. Veterinary means mostly into animal feed, and they are into animal feed. You will see here, they're into cattle feed, like the feed that is given to cattle. Then they are in poultry feed, right, for chicken and others, right? The feed that is given to them. And of course, they are the India's, I mean, India is of course the world's largest producer of milk, and they are the India's largest producer of cattle feed in India. Of course, they are also into aqua feed, like for fish and all, whatever food they eat, they also produce this. Other than this, they also like produce, if you see, feed for sheep and goats, for all of this. Like mostly they are into animal feed, right? So you just look at the numbers, like how much revenue they get from this. Now, if you go to the next segment, they are into palm oil plantation. So they have been now aggressive into this, because if you see the lines here, so India imports a significant quantity of palm oil to meet the growing demand of edible oil. So whatever edible oil you are eating at home, in that actually palm oil is there. I mean, so palm oil is processed and you get the edible oil. Now, the government of India promotes palm cultivation in certain regions of the country, right? So that India can become self-sufficient and does not import this from Malaysia and other countries. So that's why they are aggressive into this, and they are increasing the plantation cover for under this. And of course, they are India's, as they have written, we are among the largest oil palm developers in India. And of course, the other major segment they are there is crop protection. I told you the name was agriculture, agro was for agriculture. So of course, they are in agriculture, in crop protection. Here they have like different types of, I will say, protection products. Like they have plant growth regulators and biostimulants. So I cannot understand all of this, but I understand that they are in crop protection, like fertilizers and others, herbicide, fertilizers and everything. And of course, they are market leader in many of this. So they are in plant growth regulators, right? They are also into herbicides, if you see. And if you see, they are also into insecticides, fungicides, and also soil conditioners and organic manures. So basically, they are into crop protection products, and these are the categories for them. Now, other than this, these three, I will say, are the main business. Other than this, like they have two more business. One is the Godrej Tyson Foods. So you would have seen these packets if you have gone to some big bazaar or any shopping outlet, you will see this, right? They have Yummies brand, and I mean, so they have like recently started this. They are basically collaborating with Tyson Foods, that's a company US, and trying to sell packaged chicken and other this type of items. And other than that, they also have, I will say, a partnership in Bangladesh, and that name is ACI Godrej Agrovet. So they have a partnership in Bangladesh, and there also they are one of the top five, they are like one of the companies in the top five animal feed producer there also. And they again sell the same things like animal feed, I told you, like aqua feed, cattle feed, and all of this there also. And they are getting good market share there also in Bangladesh. Then they are into milk products. This is also recent. I mean, they have basically bought a company called Creamline Dairy Products, and they basically sell milk products through this. You see, like, they sell ice cream, milk powder, ghee, and everything using this. And this they have recently actually acquired. And mostly their presence of these brands are in Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, mostly in southern part, because this brand was there. I mean, this company was operating there. So that's why their most of their like products are sold in southern parts of India. Now, of course, other than that, they have a controlling stake in Aztec Life Science. So this stake was recently acquired, I think, in last 1 or 2 years. And they have like more than 51% stake in this. And this company, Aztec Life Science, this is into agrochemical active ingredients and pharmaceutical intermediates. So they build basically API. So the chemicals, all of this that goes into agrochemicals and also into the pharma, those chemicals are built by this company, Aztec Life Science. This company also exports to 25 countries. So that's why they would have bought this company, so that they can expand their products to other countries also. Other than that, they already have the crop protection business in India. So they can use this Aztec Life Science to expand their portfolio. So for both the results. Okay, this was all about how company earns money. So if you remember, what are the different segments? So of course, animal feed is important segment. Then you have palm oil cultivation, plantation. Then you have like, crop protection. And then they're also into dairy and other, chicken products that they are selling, packaged chicken products. But from those, you will see the revenue and profits are less. So if you see the segmental revenue mix up in year 2016-17, if you see animal feed was 53% and vegetable oil that I told, palm oil, was 10.2%. Crop protection was 15%. Dairy was 20%. Others was 0.8%. Now they have shifted. If you see 19-20, animal feed is still, they have decreased the dependency now only 50% from 53. And that's good actually. It should not be like one segment is contributing a lot of money. Now, if you see vegetable oil, they have decreased. It's like 9.1% now. Crop protection, again, it's almost same. In dairy, again, it's 16.2%. And of course, they have entered a new area. Because of this, you are seeing decrease in others. They have also, I told you, like poultry and processed food, that chicken packaged food items. So that's where they have like 7% revenue comes now. Now let's also see the segmental profit breakup, right? So this was the revenue breakup. And you can see like most of the revenue comes from animal feed and crop protection and dairy mostly, right? This from these three. And you see the profit breakup, like from animal feed, they get almost 40% of their profits. From crop protection, they get 38% profit. And from palm oil business, they get 22%. Now you will think that from other two segments, what they're getting, right? There are like many other segments also here. Actually, the other segments are loss making. They do not make profit. So that's why if you sum this up, this is 40, this is 40, right? And this is like more than 100%, right? That's because others are negative, right? Like they are decreasing the profit also, right? The others. If you see the margins breakup, like how much margin each of the segment gives. So of course, the highest is like if you see for crop protection, that is 29%. Palm oil is great at 61%. The margins are great here. Animal feed, if you see, like they have very less margin, only of 9.1%. This is operating margin. So they have very less margin in animal feed. But others are, crop protection is actually good, like 30% margin from this. They have good revenues also from this. If you do the return on capital employed breakup, like how much returns they get from what capital they deploy in each of this business, animal feed is the highest, almost at 60%. So they do not have to deploy much capital in this business. Crop protection, they get 31% return on capital employed. And palm oil, I will say, it's quite less now, only at around 10% now. Because still they are in investing stage in palm oil and other business. That's why you are seeing, I will say, crop protection and animal feed is their kind of very stable kind of business. That's why you do not require much capital for that. But if you are investing in some business like palm oil business and other business that I showed you, dairy business and others, they need a lot of capital there. Of course, let's go to more numbers. Like this is a kind of a small cap company, like which is investing into creating some new segments, trying to increase its market share. And they are expanding a lot. So market cap is close to 8,000 crores. Return on capital employed overall is quite good, around 20%. Debt to equity level is quite good, I will say, at 0.35. It's not very high or very low, but it's quite stable. I'm not very high also. Our dividend yield is quite good at this price, at around 1.2%. And operating margin overall is quite less, at 7-9%. Because if you see here, right? Sorry. So if you see here, like in the margins, if you see, animal feed contributes most of the revenue and profits. From them, margin is only 9.1%. I'm not sure whether it is 9.1% or 4.1%. I will again revisit this and put it in the comments. I think it's 9.1%. I will re-verify it again. No worries. So overall operating margin is just 7 to 9%. Of course, that is less. And they should try to expand this in the future. Of course, if you see from crop protection, if they start getting more revenues in the future, then you see this can increase in the future. And also there are other business also. So let's see how it goes. And also let's look at the shareholding pattern for this. Like, of course, promoters do have very good confidence in this stock, in this company. That's why they're holding around 70%. And recently when the COVID crash happened, they increased by 1%. So before this, it was 69.1%. They acquired 1% from the market during the COVID crash. Now it's 70.1%. Foreign investors are also interested in this stock at around 15%. Direct institutional investors are 4.9%. And others, like mostly this is public, is 9.7% or mutual funds. And if you see the major investors, there are like four major foreign investors here. Temasek, Aberdeen, JP Morgan, and Vanguard Fund. These all are foreign investors. Other than this, like many Indian mutual funds are invested into this, like Kotak Mutual Fund, ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund, Bajaj Holdings, Tata Mutual Fund, LIC India, all are invested in this. Now let's look at some of the numbers from past years, like their sales and everything. So if you see here, like sales has been increasing, like from 2000 crores in 2013, it's now close to 7000 crores. So that's a good increase. Profits also, if you see, from almost 200 to it's close to 500 crores now. So this is also increased. Operating margins, I will say, has been in range 7 to 9% if you see over the years, mostly because still they are over dependent on the cattle feed business, which produces less margin for them. And other income, okay, interest, of course, they have loan, debt to equity 0.35, so they have to pay the interest. And profit before tax is also increasing. And if you see the EPS also, I mean, of course, do not see the EPS because EPS directly you cannot know anything because maybe the share would have divided after that, right? That's why. So if you do get a recent number, is 13, 11, 17, 15. So that's also good. Also, let's look at the profit increase, right? That's important. So if you see the profit has increased from 100 to 300, that's like three times. That's quite great. I mean, 13 to 20, like 7 years, the profit has grown by three times. If you see the compounded sales growth, that these numbers are important. So in 5 years, sales has growth, very good growth in sales, 13%. In 3 years, 16%. And trailing 12 months, 17%. The sales are growing very fast for them. Because they're a small cap company, right? So they can expand very fast. So that's advantage with companies which have very less revenues now. Profit growth also is quite great. In 5 years, around 10%. In 3 years, around 14%. And trailing 12 months, around 23%. So they're doing quite great at these numbers. Let's look at the cash flow statement of this company. So if you see the cash from operating activity, so that from their operation, main operations, right? So this has been increasing from like 45 to 110, and it's close to now 450 crores now. This much cash they are producing from the business, and that's quite good, right? 450 crores of cash from the business. And if you see at the cash from investing activity, I told you this is a small company now. They are trying to expand. That's why you can see the numbers. They are purchasing a lot of assets. They are trying to invest more and more money into their business. That's why a lot of money is basically they are using it to buy new assets. Of course, they will be opening factories and all, right, for everything. So that's where most of the cash is going. And cash from financing activity, if you see, I mentioned in this one, like dividends paid. Of course, in the last 2 years, they have paid good amounts of dividends, around 90 crores of dividend in last 2 years. And this is also increasing. That's quite good. I told you 1.16% of dividend they are giving. Now, what are the opportunities for them in the future? That's what they have told in the annual report. They want to increase market share in already existing business, that is oil plantation. Other than that, they have animal feed, crop protection, dairy business, and poultry and products, respective products. All of these, they are trying to gain market share in that. And they are trying to basically, second point, if you see, Pan India presence with extensive supply and distribution network to benefit company long run. So they want to be all over India. That's what they want to expand, basically all over India. And also diversified business with synergies in operation. So they do not want to have any operation that does not have any synergy with each other. So if you see almost all of their business are quite related to each other, right? Animal feed, dairy, animal products, all of these are quite related to each other. If you see, it's not that, okay, one is quite different from other. It's not the same. And of course, for these type of companies, they need strong research and development organization, right? Because they are into crop protection, animal feed. They need to like come up with new products, innovative products, so that they can gain market share in this. And of course, last is focus on inorganically growing business. So of course, maybe they can also acquire. Of course, they acquired Aztec Life Sciences, then dairy business, they have acquired. So they also are looking for this opportunity in the future. This is my view on this stock. So if you see this, like they are quite diversified in agriculture and animal feed mostly, like agrochemicals, animal feed, palm oil, dairy, everything. They are quite diversified in this. And they have good promoters, the Godrej Group, plus like they have good, confidence in this company. Like they are holding 70% of this stock and they're buying after the crash also. So they do have confidence. And if you see market share increase in all, so understand this, in all the segments that they operate, all of these are quite unorganized segments, if you see. So animal feed, if you see, or maybe palm cultivation or plantation or dairy, like these all are, quite, or poultry, right? All of these are quite unorganized segments. And they are an organized company and they are trying to gain market share from unorganized company in this segment. That's how they are trying to increase their market share in this. Also, if you look on the valuation side, there is a similar company actually, which is in animal feed. Of course, this is a kind of animal feed company now because around 50% of the revenue and profits comes from that. So if there is a similar company called KSE, that stock is also listed. If you compare the valuation with that, almost valuation is quite same for both. And of course, this is a small cap stock. So I think for small cap stock, looking at valuation may not be the best thing, because they are growing so fast that whatever valuation they have, in the future, that those valuations will not mean anything, And of course, I am invested in this stock, and this is the only, agrochemical stock in my portfolio. Only agrochemical. Tata Chemicals I have, but they are not mostly into agrochemicals. They have rallies, but that is subsidiary. This is a kind of totally agrochemical and into animal feed. So this is the only type of stock in my portfolio. And I will be holding this for long term. So this is for long term. Let this company, grow into like mid cap first and then into large cap company. So I am holding this for long term. So that's my view on this stock. Do provide your views also in this stock, like if you do have any points, positive points or negative points on this stock. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.